Om pam 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 That's gonna be our intro for today. This is a game against Zach, who was on my stream. I can't actually remember. You know what? I'm just going to minimize my thing right in the middle. Go check the people I've battled. And his name was Soot Dump. That's it. Soot Dumpling. That's who he was. So we'll have a game here. And I just put some stuff together, which was, I guess, essentially UU. Though I don't know if there is a UU or if there's this beta thing or what's... I don't know what's going on. All that matters is I U-turn on the Aggron with my Darmanitan, go into Empoleon, who dodges a head smash, which is pretty nice, not going to lie. But I'm then predicting him to go for an Earthquake, which is why I switch out to my Swellen. You have to note, of course, that the Aggron is not going Mega, so I assume that he's not running one, and instead is running a Choice Banded set, which is why he wanted to switch, because he was locked into the head smash. However, getting the double switch, because we both pull a double, from Swallow into Shedinja is actually real good for me, because I carry Pursuit on this Swallow, and I made sure to do that because of stupid situations like that which can occur. Obviously now Shedinja's out of the way. It was also weird that it didn't have a Focus Sash. People were suggesting it had safety goggles on, which is definitely a feasible thing with Sandstorm and Hail and stuff, so I guess that's probably what he's running. But I'm not going to stay in on the Electros. You turn out into Amoongus, who can definitely deal with any kind of thing this thing hopes to do. You know, not the best because I'm more specially defensive and he has Coil, so he's more physical, but I can at least take a hit. Even at plus one, you know, it's a neutral crunch, you know, it's not stabbed, it's not very powerful. So getting that thing to sleep, I can switch out, get Regenerator boost back up to full or, you know, close to it after lefties and all that stuff. So I'm not too worried. And hopefully Amoongus will live to see many more days. But for now, knowing that he is most likely going to switch into something to combat me directly, I decide to pull off the double powder after sporing on the first turn, going for Stun Spore on the second in the incoming Darmanitan, which for some goddamn reason has a rogue Lumberry, which I couldn't get through my head. Why would you? It doesn't make a huge amount of sense, but I mean, it works perfectly for his situation, and I am basically forced to go into something to die, because unfortunately, as much as I liked the UU stuff I brought, I didn't have anything that could take fire hits very well. Empoleon, I mean, is neutral, so I just, it wasn't a good time. Anyway, I'm going to end up going for a Surf here. I don't know why he switched. That is something that really I haven't been able to figure out. Maybe he was predicting me to double into something and then went into Electros. But why would he go into Electros? Because it's asleep. It's at a disadvantage. I'm not sure. Maybe it was just some kind of strange misplay in his head. I do that sometimes, so I can't really blame him. But yeah, not really understanding how that was going. Anyway, I managed to kill the Electros for free, which is perfect. It also means that now that thing is gone, I can put something else to sleep, which I'm pretty psyched about. And again, this doesn't make a whole lot of sense. The reason for running Fire Blast on Darmanitan would only really be if you're running Zen mode, which I don't think he was. It looked like he was going with just straight up Sheer Force. The actual fact behind that is that he misclicked on Fire Blast instead of Flare Blitzing, which is why I'm able to live it and kill him with Surf. And for some reason, this Empoleon, which I literally brought in to die to Flare Blitz from Darmanitan, not only ends up killing the Darmanitan, but also ends up killing an Electros as an added bonus, so whatever. Klawitz is going to kill me with the Aura Sphere, but I'm going to now bring in my Amoongus, who can easily deal with that thing, especially since it's probably scarfed and locked in, and that is exactly what happens. It goes for one, gets a crit, which utterly does nothing to my poor little shroom, and I can just, you know, I can start plowing away now with some Giga Drains and some other good stuff, and hopefully, you know, do well. So I Giga Drain on the Aggron switch in, which does, you know, it's not too bad, especially considering that I don't have any investment. Aggron doesn't have the best special defense in the world, so puts me in a nice position to take that thing down. I'm going to go into Fortress now because it's my physically defensive poke. And Jesus, Fortress is pretty massive this gen. And he ends up getting another crit. I don't know. It's not really like it matters a huge amount, in all honesty. But, my Fortress doesn't appreciate it, I'll tell you that much. Now, switches up to Superpower here, which I thought was bit of a strange move. I'm not sure if he would have taken me out with a second head smash, but he certainly would have got closer than he would have done by going for superpower. Maybe he was also afraid of it missing again, so that's potential. But I get up a free layer of spikes, which I'm not complaining about, and he does see some sense and goes back to head smash after superpowering. But he is, you know, defense lowered at this point, so I'm going to bring in my own Darmanitan. I'm going to go for the superpower, and despite the damage-reducing berry that he has given to his Aggron, I'm able to smash it out the park with a superpower because of that four times super effective damage. Of course, Aggron in its normal form is rock and steel. It goes pure steel when it megas, but he was susceptible to superpower there. So I'm going to switch out on the Heracross because it's probably scarfed, and it's I'm locked into superpower, and it's definitely not a good thing to do. Obviously, no, he's not scarfed. Why would I say he's obviously scarfed? We just saw that he didn't have a Mega Aggron, so his Mega is definitely going to be Heracross, if nothing else. Anyway, switching to Amoongus, which, again, what is it with crits this game? Amoongus gets critted by the close combat, which is a huge amount, but I really was using this thing as death fodder. Of course, I have the Swellow on my team, which means I can easily take down Mega Cross no matter what. It's going to be a simple task, ladies and gentlemen. So Swellow comes in, and Brave Bird shall finish it. And then I believe his last is the Clawitzer, which is still asleep. And because of that, I'm going to get to kill it off pretty easily. I don't think he even is able to outspeed Swellow with the Choice Scarf, because Swellow is super quick, and Clawitzer, I think, is like base 59, so even with the Scarf attached, it's not going to be outspeeding me. I don't know why I go for Brave Bird here. Facade is the more powerful move, and it would have one-shotted him, but I end up Brave Birding instead, which doesn't make a difference, because he does stay asleep for that turn, allowing me to not only just about live on 3 HP with the poison, but end the game with a Facade, and Clawitzer taken down. Goodbye. Absolutely great. So that's the game. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I am away. Well, I'm at home this weekend, which is why I'm pre-recording these. So hopefully this will go up on, like, I don't know, Saturday or something, or Friday. I don't. I honestly haven't figured it out, but it will. Something like that. There's some arrangement that'll happen. Yeah. So leave a like if you enjoyed. That would be appreciated. And I will see you guys in the next battle when that happens to be. I don't know. It could be sometime in the future. So I'll see you then. Bye.